Hey guys, Corey here. I am, one room into a fairly big job here. I've got 5 rooms and stairs to go. So still plenty of house to clean here. Make another Challenger video. Let me show you what I've done and what I've got to do yet. So I've got some Floorcare or something, whatever that stuff is the kids make. I was gonna patch it, but it looks like it's something I can clean out of the carpet. So I've done it before. You never know what you're gonna get. I mean, I might wind up patching it, but it looked to me like something I might be able to clean out. So anyway, let me show you what I've done, then we'll look at the rest of it. All right, this hallway and the one bedroom down here has been done. All right, all this has been done. I'm doing my sprayers different today. I added a different sprayer. I bought one of the Scott sprayers finally. Using this guy with a moderate mix. And then the other sprayer, this one here, the Scott's, has the stronger stuff in it because you don't, basically this guy here produces the air, pushes it through. So the only seals that get hit or in here, whereas with the other one, when you're running a high powered mix through it, you're soaking the pump in it. So I'm gonna keep my chemicals separate here. All right, I've got this room to do here, and I've got this room to do right here. This guy, I've had it soaking in ammonia several different applications, so it's softening up. I'm gonna run the scouring pad over it first, and then we'll see about extracting it. I think we might have a little bit left. It's I don't know. Kids make that stuff, and I guess it depends on how much of whatever ingredient they put in it. Some was harder to remove than others. Anyway, I'm gonna pre-spray these two rooms here. I'll show the pre-spraying of these two rooms actually, since they're so small.
Thank you.
All right, I'm gonna switch over to time lapse and clean this room right quick. All right, guys, I am going to scrub. I got the scrubbing pad on this one here. We'll talk about the challenger more here in a minute. I'm gonna scrub the whole room. Let me go get that sprayer and just show you it. Had several guys tell me I should get one of these, and I finally did. I got it mainly just to keep the stronger chemicals in. You can see it's got a green light on it. This is the on off here, and when it gets to a certain PSI, it clicks back on and it starts airing it up again. So it uses air, not a pump. So it has an air pump that pumps the thing full, and this guy will screw onto any Scott's sprayer. So, I mean, it's nothing to it. You plug it in here and you charge it. Now, it doesn't put out pre-spray at the same rate as the other one. The Ryobi sprayer, it puts out a lot of pre-spray fast. This guy here, when you hear it hanging out, I guess I'm gonna plug that back in there. Anyway, let's show you how this works. And this is the strong stuff. I just wanted to show how this works. This will get the job done. It also comes in a 3 gallon. This guy will fit on the 1, 2, or 3 gallon sprayer. Price point is about $80 on this. The Ryobi is 150, I believe. Except the battery that goes on Ryobi, you can put a battery on it that runs you $150 as well. The 6 hour battery. All right, now we gotta hope that I didn't lie here and I can get this out. This is ammonia. One thing like this one is probably going to take a patch. what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna switch out and we're gonna go time lapse, because I don't know what all I'm gonna have to do to this thing, and we're not gonna do it play by play. I'm gonna put it on time lapse, change out my towel, and we're gonna clean this whole room. So back in a second. Got it drying it out real fast so I can come and patch it later. All right, I've got this much here, this room here, and the stairs, and then one room, I think, in a closet downstairs. So we're gonna pre-spray this hall here, and we'll watch me clean that. We'll do this in time lapse, I guess, and then we'll do this room here. This room here has got some fairly fancy stuff going on. It's fairly soil. I picked up as much as I could, and I put stuff different places. Anyway, that's a nice couch. That's leather. That is cool. Yep. All right, I'm going to set it up, and we are going to clean that hallway. Show the difference between how these both of these guys spray. It looks like we got them in good view here. All right, this is the Ryobi. All right, and this is the Scotts. There you go. Give you an idea. You know, how much pre-spray each one of them puts out. So, they both have their own place. All right, I'm going to switch to time-lapse. So I'm going to clean the hallway all the way to here. All right, guys, did this section of hallway here. Now we're gonna turn around and we're gonna do this area here. So what we're gonna do here is this one is going to get a scrub. It makes the carpet, it makes it come cleaner when you scrub and then you extract. So we're gonna pre-spray, then you're gonna see me scrub with one towel, and then you're gonna see me extract with another. Keep in mind, I guess I'm gonna have to start putting this in every video. This is the Challenger. It is not a rotary machine. It's an orbital. It's completely different. If you're interested in purchasing a Challenger, I'm a Challenger dealer. This channel is where you learn how to clean with Challenger. You're also welcome to text me if you purchase one through me and ask me questions. I also send you $100 as a rebate out of my pocket when you purchase a Challenger through me. So I'm going to try to put that in every video. That's something you're not going to get with any other dealer anywhere. You're not going to waste their time talking to you after they've already sold you a machine and you have short questions. All right, I'm going to pre-spray this guy here, and then we're going to scrub, and then we're going to extract. All right, looks pretty clean. Now, what we're gonna do here, this one is gonna take two different machines. This guy is gonna take the Oryx up here and on the stair, and then the Challenger down here. So it is good to have different size machines. I've also got the Mighty on the van, but it rarely gets taken out because it's 125 pounds and it is a monster, it's a beast. So when you're doing residential, you're gonna want a Challenger for damn sure, and definitely an Oryx. You gotta have an Oryx if you're gonna do BLM inside a house, because there's no way you're gonna reach everywhere unless you have a small machine. All right, guys, we are a little bit dark in here right now. Not really anything I can do about that. Some more lights I can turn on. When I pan out, it's a little brighter. This is better than when I was looking back the other direction. I'm going to pre-spray all of this, and I'm gonna do this whole thing in time lapse. So you'll see me pre-spray the top and the bottom, and you'll see me use the Oryx on top and the stair, and then the Challenger on the bottom here. So getting ready to get started. All right, guys, we are moving along pretty good here. This guy is done now. So now it's time to do the stairs. I'm gonna go ahead and cover the stairs in time lapse as well, because I usually don't. Now also, Challenger also makes these triple thick towels for the Oryx, and they also make a driver for the Oryx as well. So these guys clean considerably better than the Oryx stock stuff. So this is all aftermarket created by Challenger. I can help you with that too. The number is 512-350-1129. So you're welcome to text if you want information about either buying a Challenger or any of the products for Oryx. The towels, the drivers, big towels for the big machine. This guy here. So this is an entire carpet cleaning system. It's the most inexpensive way to get into the business and do an incredibly good job. All right, I'm gonna treat all of this, and I'm gonna try to cover the cleaning of it. All right, guys, we're on the last room here. This is the master bedroom downstairs. I think it's got the most soil of all the carpet. So we're gonna spray this. First, I'm gonna spray it with a standard spray here, basically. And then I'm gonna go over it with the super strong spray just to get a little more. Then I'm gonna scrub it, and then I'm gonna extract it. And we should have just about new carpet here by the time I'm done. Area by the door is going to be the dirtiest, and this is a Frieze. So Frieze is probably the most challenging carpet you'll do. Berber is probably about as difficult, but Frieze is the one that will make you look silly if you don't know what you're doing and how to deal with it. Anyway, I'm going to pre-spray everything, I'm going to do that in time lapse, and I'll stop before I start cleaning, and then talk for a second, and then I'll clean it in time lapse as well. All right, I've got the scrub pad underneath it, so we're gonna scrub this whole room here, and then we're gonna clean it. So I will I'm gonna do that in time lapse. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just kind of move the camera around as I go. So here we go. You're gonna see the scrub first, then I'm gonna switch out, and then I'm gonna do the extraction, and then we'll have a look at everything, and we should have just about new looking carpet by the time I'm done. All done. All right, guys, I appreciate you watching. I'm going to put up all these tools here, and then I'm going to go make a patch upstairs on the blue that I couldn't make come out. Anyway, if you're interested in joining the Challenger Army, shoot me a text and I can talk to you about getting you a Challenger and getting your small business started up for not all that much money. We do financing now, so you're in good shape. Thanks for watching, guys, and God bless. See you on the next video.